Everybody. My name's Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build my 6x6 double volt door you can see here in front of you. First, what's a double volt door? Maybe you have already seen a volt door, which looks pretty much like this. But the normal volt doors have one little disadvantage, in my opinion, and that is that if you go to the back of it, you get to see a lot of pistons and redstone, and with a double volt door you get to see exactly the same volt door design from both sides. So that's what a double volt door is. Now, just to show you how it works. Okay, some graphical glitches going on here, but as you can see, it opens rather fast. The closing is a bit slower and more sequenced, but I think it looks not too bad. I had one version that was a lot faster than this one here and had a really nice sequence, but unfortunately this got broken when the slime blocks got introduced, so I had to redesign the whole thing, and well, that's what I came up with. So now, how big is this door? Well, it's 16 blocks wide, has a depth of 7 blocks, and is 14 blocks high. Now for the resources you will need. Of course you need some kind of building block. Then for the circuits you will need 6 glowstone blocks. I used an additional 12 blocks here in the doorway to make it look a bit more interesting. Then you will need 46 slime blocks and 75 obsidian blocks. For the circuits you need 1 stack of redstone, half a stack of redstone repeaters, 27 redstone torches and 45 sticky pistons. And for the control I used in this case an additional 2 redstone, 1 redstone torch and 1 additional lever here on this side here. Okay, so that's what you need and how much space you need. So let's start with the building. Okay, so first, after you have decided where you want the door to be, mark the center of the door with 4 obsidian blocks at the floor level, like this. Then from one of the edges you go down 1 block and place an obsidian block. Then go down 2 more blocks and place an upwards facing sticky piston so that there is a gap of 2 blocks, and place a normal block on top of it. Then place a block on each side of this piston and a repeater on 2 ticks going from the block above the sticky piston like this. Then run this into a block, then a torch on the side of the block, another block on top of the torch, on top on the side of this block put another torch, 2 torches I mean, finally another block here, another block here, another block here in this little U shape, and finally some redstone dust on this side here, on this block here. Now mirror this on the other side like this. Okay, now place some redstone here on the block, place a block here and redstone torch on top of it, on the side of it. Okay, next place 5 more obsidian blocks, 2 here, diagonally to those 2 blocks here, 1 here, and finally 2 on this side here. Okay, now go down to this block here with the torch and place diagonally again another block here, then one more, then go up one block, to the side, one block up, like this, then another block here. Then place a glowstone block above this torch here, and a normal block on the side of it. Then place three normal blocks like this. Go down one and place another three blocks like this. Then from this block here, go down one to the side like this and place another two blocks like this. Okay, now it's time for some redstone. Place a redstone repeater here, then some more redstone here, redstone repeater here, going into this obsidian block here on four ticks. Another repeater here on one tick, some more redstone. Then two repeaters here, one on four ticks and one on two ticks. Finally another one in the default condition, default setting on this one. And finally here, one redstone and a repeater in the default setting. Okay. So now it's time to go to the other side and place a few more circuits here. For this, from this block above the extended piston, go two more to this side here. Below the four obsidian blocks we placed in the beginning. Then go down one block and place four blocks in a row like this. Then on the side of it, place 30 blocks like this, and on the side of this, place another two blocks like this. Then go up one block, and one block down again like this. Then go to the side here, and place two blocks like this. Go down one, and place two blocks to the side like this. Now grab some obsidian, and place one block below this obsidian block here. Good, now it's time for some redstone. For this, place some redstone on those blocks here, all the way to the back here. Then two more on this side, and three more on this one, those blocks here. Finally one block, piece of obsidian redstone here. Now grab some repeaters. Place one here on three ticks, another one on three ticks here. Finally two more here, one on four ticks and one on one tick. Okay. Now it's time to place some pistons. For this, place one sticky piston above this redstone repeater here, in front of this repeater here. Then one more here. The same on this side here. Then grab some slime blocks and place four in a row, connecting those two pistons here, the same on this side here. Then grab a few more sticky pistons and place them facing upwards on the side of this slime blocks here. And finally place some normal blocks on top of the sticky pistons and the slime blocks. Like this. And now we can actually try out this part of the door. For this, just power this redstone line here, which is also the input for the whole door later on. And as you can see, the extension works, and the retraction also works, like it should. Okay. Next, grab some obsidian blocks and start placing them like this. So, from this block up, go one out and one up. Then place another three blocks here and go down again. So get this little archway here out of five obsidian blocks like this. Then leave a gap of two blocks and mirror this one to the top. Like this. Then go to this side here. Leave one block wide gap and place a column of six obsidian blocks like this. The same on this side here. And now mirror those obsidian blocks here to this side here. So, the little archway. Then one of the columns. The mirrored archway. And finally another column. Like this. Okay. Now, if you want, you can already start placing the obsidian blocks of the ceiling, so just mirror off the floor for this. And you're pretty much done. Now, if you want to lighten up this place a bit, you can already start placing a few extra glowstone blocks in the corners here and here. But you can also use normal blocks instead of those glowstone blocks here. Okay, now it's time to place some more redstone. For this, place a block in front of this redstone here, a redstone torch on the side of this, a block above this, then four more block above this one, then go up one block and place four blocks like this, then go down one and place a 2x3 platform here and one additional block here. Now start placing a few torches, one here, one on the side of this block here, and three on top of these blocks here. Then a redstone repeater on 2 ticks here, a repeater on 4 ticks here, another repeater on 2 ticks here. I'm sorry, make this on 2 ticks and this on 4 ticks. And finally 4 redstone like this. Okay, now place the same on this side here, so in front of the repeater here, a block, then block above it, and another on the side of it. One up, and place 4 blocks in a row. Then the little 3x2 platform, and the additional block here. Torch, torch, and another 3 torches here. Repeater on 2 ticks. Repeat on 2 ticks, repeat on 4 ticks, and 4 redstone. Like this, and don't forget the torch down here. Okay. So now grab some obsidian blocks again and place 3 above these torches here. Then place a normal block above this torch, torch on top of it, normal block and some redstone on top of it. Then place a normal block on top of this block here, some redstone here, block to the side here, and torch on top of it like this. So then above this repeater here, place a normal block, then to the side here another block, place 2 repeaters on those on 2 ticks, and place in front of them, facing to the side, 1 sticky piston like this. Okay. Then 2 sticky pistons here and 1 sticky piston here. Finally, 3 slime blocks like this. Okay. Now, normal block on top of this torch here, normal block here, a repeater on 2 ticks here. Then normal block behind this piston here, another repeater on 2 ticks, run it into another block here, then another block here, this time it's a glowstone block, and some redstone on top of it, like this. Okay. Good. Now mirror this. First, place 6 slime blocks in a column like this, in front of the sticky piston here, and the same on this one here. And now just rebuild this circuit on the other side here. So for that you have here 3 obsidian blocks here, then block above here, repeat, torch, block, and redstone. Then block here, some redstone, block up here, torch, then normal block here, normal block here, two repeaters on two ticks, the sticky pistons in front of them, one and two. You can already place the slime blocks if you want. Then two sticky pistons, another sticky piston, and three slime blocks. Then block up here, block here. Repeat on two ticks, another block here, repeat on two ticks, another block here, and finally block of glowstone with some redstone on top of it. Now we can actually place another four sticky pistons, and the same here. And finally we can start placing the blocks of the doorway. And to make it a bit more interesting, place some glowstone blocks here. Again, this can be normal blocks. And now just open and close it a few times, and as you can see, now it's flat, and if you now close it, we have, of course, we have a little problem here, but this will be fixed in a second. So for this, place a block of glowstone obsidian here, some redstone on top of it, then a torch on top of this block here, block here, then another block here, block of glowstone above the piston here, and another block here, and run some redstone along like this. The same on this side here. So like this, and now it should close completely. So, as you can see, it closes and opens like it should. Okay, so the last thing we have to build is the ceiling part of the door. For this, go to this side here and place a piece of glowstone above this redstone here on the obsidian. Then place two normal blocks like this, grab some obsidian, place three blocks here, then leave one block wide gap here, and place another obsidian, place some redstone in the gap, normal block on top of this gap here, then another normal block up here, normal block here, normal block here, obsidian block down here, another obsidian block down here, grab some redstone and run it on those blocks here. Then put a repeater on four ticks here, a repeater on three ticks here, another here, a repeater on two ticks here. Then grab two torches and place them on the side of this block here. Sticky piston facing upwards here, another one here, normal block on top of it. Then block to the side, and a repeater on three ticks running out of this block here. Then finding a row of four blocks here and one block up here, and some redstone on top of those blocks here. The same thing on this side here. So repeat on three ticks, block up here, row of four blocks with some redstone on top of them. Now it's time to grab some sticky pistons and place them facing downwards, one here and one here, another 4 in a row like this, and connect them all with 4 slime blocks. Same thing on this side here. Then finally place the blocks of the actual door. And now it's time to give it a little try. And as you can see, it closes completely and also opens completely. Now last thing to do is filling in the floor and the ceiling with some more blocks. And now, to make the use of this door a bit more practical, we have to relocate this lever here. The easiest solution is just going up a few blocks here, placing some redstone here, torch on this side, and putting the lever here or here, wherever you want it. And as you can see, now you can open and close the door from here. And this is just some ghost blocks going on. Okay. So that was how you can build my 6x6 double vault door. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. And, well, see ya.